Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's ask the question, is the software market too saturated? All right, so today I want to respond to a couple of comments on yesterday's video. Yesterday's video was called, Can Anyone Become a Software Developer? Where I had a little bit of a rant about the developers I was working with, the fact that they were kept asking these questions on stuff that I was just able to Google. And I said that basically you have to have the right mindset to become a software developer rather than the mental capacity. I think anybody could do it, but they need to be able to dig and really put in the long hours and the digging. And not many people are willing or prepared to do that. But there were some really good comments came from that. First of all, I said I may have talked about that topic before. And sure enough, Byron Lovelace said, number 239, January 19th, 2019, can anyone be an app developer? Same story. Dude, I'm sorry. Dude, sometimes I say the same thing again and again. It's not on purpose. My kids say the same thing too. Dad, you told us this already. So sorry about that. I'm guilty, right? I'm sorry about that. However, Byron also came with another comment, which was really good. He said, real question is it still worth becoming a software developer? 21 million devs in the world. Does supply outstrip demand? Labor can be found cheaply. Jobs are scarce. Only a select few make it FAANG companies. Entrepreneurship is hard. Nobody wants to pay for apps. Only SaaS generates the kind of revenue to make it worthwhile, but many fail at that. Jobs are slavery. Contracting is a hollow experience. And client work is just another form of working for somebody else. Software dev takes a lot of time and effort to get good at it. Is it really worth it? Okay, this is a really good question, Byron. It's something that I've been thinking about a lot too. It's almost like we're on the same wavelength because a lot of times I'm working with developers and I work with so many developers. And a lot of times it's like, I'll talk to developers. Like, I'm not working with this guy. Like, it's just, he doesn't know anything. And a lot of times I'll be working with companies and I'll start working with somebody and I'll say, I gotta get rid of this guy. I'm not working with him. He's terrible. And it's over the course of my career, there've been a lot of times where people try to assess how I am as a software developer, or you try to assess how somebody else is as a software developer. And it's not really a good way of doing it. I've done the tests, the exams, writing sample code, sending code samples, all that kind of stuff. And I've had people do that when I was hiring them, and it's really difficult to do. But when you work with other software developers in a team, like when I was working in software teams, you knew who the good people were and who the people were who, you know, and there was always one real hot shot, right? And it was usually like the manager never knew how good he was, right? The manager never knew how good he was, but the other developers knew how good he was, or they would go to him and ask questions because he was really, you know, him or her, it could have been her, but were really good at what they do. And there's always a few people that you would go to, and there was other people who were just like, you know, phoning it in, right? But I do think it's getting more saturated where we have more and more people coming into the market. Which is one of the reasons why I never go on Upwork. I mean, every time I've gone on Upwork, I've had a bad experience. I've had a couple good experiences, but for the most part, it seems like it's a lot of people who claim to be really good at something, but when you really drill down, they're not. And I worry about people who don't know anything about software or code to even be able to tell the difference, right? You know, it's scary when you talk to somebody and they go, oh yeah, our developer told us it was going to be, you know, 6 months to do that, or this wasn't possible, or that was possible, or that's just the way this works. And you're like, well, that's not true. They're obviously not doing it the right way because they don't know any better. And that's the scary thing about Upwork. That's the scary thing about hiring somebody when you don't know what you're looking for. And that's why if you have somebody who's really good at what they're doing, a lot of times if they're in a job, then, you know, they're well paid, or if they can, nobody wants to get rid of them. There was another really good comment though that came in from Leo Fonseca, which kind of follows on from it. I just think this is really fascinating point for discussion. I don't really have a solution to it, but Leo says, sure, just as an infinite number of monkeys sitting at typewriters might eventually churn out the entire works of Shakespeare, To add to Byron's point below, the fact that the industry is saturated with LMGTFY, let me Google that for you, hacks and IP theft, plagiarism is rampant, and certifications demonstrate mostly memorization ability and not critical thinking and problem solving. The market is getting saturated with junk slash clone software apps too. Okay, again, I struggle with this too. When my application was doing well and it kept getting removed from Google because it was successful, but it was unique when I came up with it. And every week I had to go through and remove the copycats. And now the copycats run it. And I don't mean copycats like it's a similar idea or whatever, but you know, the same icon, the same description, the same everything. And I've seen it everywhere. I've seen it on LinkedIn where someone copies my profile word for word and changes my name to their name, right? Which is like, which was just ridiculous. Why would you do that? And you do see this IP theft and plagiarism all over the place. And when I read you guys' comments, I do sometimes think about that. I think, oh, is it even worth doing anymore? Is it become too saturated? Is it, you know, software development isn't like some super successful job. It's a job. You know, people are good at it and people are bad at it. It's not magic. And it really is. If you find a software developer who's good, and again, it's not a high percentage of them, right? It's not. Then you cling to that person because they're worth their weight in gold. But there's so many people out there who are just hacks, who are just phoning it in. And I talk to them all the time, and it does get depressing. And maybe it is getting too saturated. I mentioned before I have two kids who started university this year. One of them started a bit later because he went into the Army. But one of them is studying film production, which is, you know, good, I guess. You know, I'm sure that's really saturated too. And the other one has gone into cyber forensics, which I just thought was badass. I thought was really cool because if he told me he wanted to be an app developer, I would have been a bit concerned because I think it might be hard to get a job in that field or in software or whatever, because there's so many people who claim to do it, right? Unless you could stand out in a crowd, right? I worry about that. I worry about the fact that there's so many people going into software that the really good ones can't stand out because they're not thinking about the marketing, how they're going to market themselves. I could tell you, okay, with no pride, I will tell you this. I know that there are contracts I worked at where there were people who were far more talented than I was. Like, they were the guy, right? They were like, I learned so much from them, right? Or, you know, I could just see how good they were, but the manager didn't know it. Or, you know, like, I was better paid than they were. I was the go-to guy, and it should have probably been the other guy, right? Because he was not interested I would say the politics, you could say the brown nosing, whatever it was. He wasn't interested in how good a CV looked. He was interested in the technology. He was a player. He was a guy who did what he was supposed to do. He was a guy, you know, the guy you want on your team. And my, you know, there, if I had to pick my all-star team of developers, you know, there's a lot of these guys who would have been on it, but like, you know, they were unsung. They just didn't do it. And this is the problem with the saturation of the markets. I know I'm kind of rambling on a little bit today. It's an interesting topic to think about. It's interesting to think about, is it too saturated? You know, I think a lot of markets are saturated, especially when they have a low barrier to entry. Software actually does have a high barrier to entry, but it's easy for anybody to learn the basics and then claim to be an expert, because I see it all the time. Thank you very much, Byron and Leo, for your comments, really interesting. Let me know what the rest of you guys think. I'm a little bit depressed now. What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do with this saturated market? But honestly, I think every market is getting saturated. Cyber forensics isn't. But don't go into that, because I want my son to be able to get a job. I hope you guys are having a great day. I'll talk to you again tomorrow.